Hello, people on the internet. Welcome back to Estonia. It's been a long, long month for me, and I finally managed to upgrade my PC. So the last few weeks have been pretty hectic, and I'm trying to get my open broadcast software working and to get the maximum out of my new setup of 7700K and GTX 1080 Ti. On the background, I'll have one pretty good match for me. It was pretty hectic and a real tight match. I almost pulled this one out of my ass, but at the end I fell a little short. But I stopped grinding my Germans and Russians, because in the German tree I'm up to 7.0s, and in the Russian tree I have my IT1, so I have been playing a little of Brits and Americans. And as you can see in the American lineup, I have my 5.3 Shermans, which are most of the time facing Panthers and Tigers that pretty much one-shot me all the time. And in this desert push, at first I'll try to hit the enemy tank straight ahead on, but I fail. And the second try will be much better. But in regards of the computer, I set it all up, bought the parts, compiled it together, first time for me, setting my whole PC up by myself. It's nothing much that people can't handle, I think. You watch a few videos, you take extra special care, and of course it takes a lot more time than those professional guys like JD2Sense or Bitwit or people like that, but I managed to do it in few hours. And of course I had my few slip-ups. For instance, I forgot to remove my CPU cooler protective film and the first temperatures were like idling in the high 60s. But all in all, it works pretty fine, and as you can see here, I'm facing a Panther at 600 meters, and my gun accuracy is so shit, I can't hit him or kill him in 3 hits, and I pretty much die after they spot me. So the Sherman is a bit of a sneaky peeky tank, and you should only hit the enemies from the side, but unfortunately the speed of this tank is not so good. It doesn't allow you to get in these positions where you can run from the enemy and set yourself up for side shots. But somehow in this match I managed to do so, and at some point, like you can see in here, we have 3 capture points, and this almost looks like a full-blown run over of the enemy team. But the problem is, people start to overextend. We have 3 caps, everybody rushes past the cap points to the enemy spawn, and this is the shit that costs us the match. They overextend, people coming from spawn in numbers, and are picking our guys off one by one. And as you can see later on, one Tiger comes from their northwest spawn, runs down all the points, and then I kill him, but it's too late. What else? I had some issues with War Thunder. I couldn't play it for like 2 or 3 weeks because some bullshit of the Windows settings, and it took a pretty hefty amount of time to dig in so deep that I found the solution, thanks to all the guys that helped. I saw some videos on the YouTube regarding this issue, and lucky for me that it worked for me. So I left the video up, and maybe it helped someone else too. Now you see I took out my second Sherman. I almost make a mistake here, trying to evade shots from 2-3 enemy tanks, and I stopped for a second to take a better range shot that could have been lethal. They almost had me range down, and meaning every shot they took came closer and closer. Here I meet my first real opponent. The enemy, I believe it's KV-754 or something, that has upgraded armor and better German gun. It's a pretty decent PMM vehicle, and it's really hard to penetrate it. As you can later see, the only place you can penetrate it almost every time is the lower plate. But in here I try to set up for side shots, and I'm lucky to evade his shots, and he bounces one of them. And after that there is two very little small cheek like bones or cheek sides in this tank that you can penetrate, and I managed to bounce this one, but he shot again and I bounced again, so I take a better aim next time and I penetrate it.
Yes, a hit!
This gives me a little more time to prepare my next shot, but I don't need it because I get help from my teammates. So now I'm in a pretty good position for this tank. It's relatively high profile, but the houses are pretty tall, and they are very close together, so this gives me good opportunity to run around the houses, spot enemy tanks in the third person view. And in here you can see spot some movement, but I don't know how.
Got it!
I didn't see that Tiger beforehand. I saw that he was spotted on the map, but he ran past me, his side on, and this is the perfect example of this shitty gun having one shot capabilities. Because you can only like regularly kill tigers and panthers with side shots. I don't know how I missed this panther at the first, but now I see him, and aiming down the sights, I lose him again for a second. It's good that I didn't take a shot. Take a shot, boom, through the ammo, one shot kill. This Sherman type of vehicle can play pretty decent in this urban environment, but you have to be able to know and see around you what is happening. In here I get pretty easy to anti-aircraft kills. I botch up this shot, but I get in with my second shot. And another place for a good mistake is here. I enter the cap and I don't pay attention. I'm in the cap and I'm not capping, meaning that there's someone else in the cap zone. So when I notice it, I'm going to slowly back out of the area and trying to look for the enemy. I believe the enemy tank that is in the area hasn't noticed the white markers on the cap circle in the upper middle section of the screen, because otherwise he would have known that someone else was with him in the cap zone. And this gives me another good side shot on enemy panther. It will come up in a second. I'm currently still looking. If I'm looking over these replays, sometimes I notice that even I don't pay much attention to my surroundings. sometimes you can spot enemy tanks in the replays way ahead of them really appearing on my crosshairs. I used my mortar in here and I didn't see him. Right. So, lucky for me, he didn't see me too. I killed him and I entered the cap zone for a cap. Now, if you're looking at the map, you see that a large portion of my allies are dead. So it means that they are either in their planes or out of the game already. And this match still seemed like an easy victory for us. I'm captain of the zone and I'm now trying to stay hidden because the enemies are coming from left and front. As you can see on the map, they are capturing the B point. But there are people on my left and I almost again make a mistake trying to follow this plane with my tank, and if I would shoot at the plane with my commander's machine gun at this moment, I would give away my position. I was thinking about it many times, but seeing that the plane isn't coming after me, I don't make a shot, and as you can see, a few seconds later, I see this enemy tiger. So my first intentions were to back out of the position and give him a side shot, but since this tank is so slow, I move forward and get this lucky quick shot with a little gap. A few seconds later and he would have passed that gap and I could have taken the shot anymore. And another anti-air kill. So far, really good fat match for me, 7 kills, and if we look back, I didn't get any kills with my first tank, only got 3 hits and that was it. I see this enemy KV pushing down the hill and I'm setting up a sneaky snap trap tactics for him, waiting for him to come out. But I should have taken a lower plate shot, disabling his driver and disabling his track, but lucky for me I get his turret ring, meaning that he cannot move his turret anymore. So I'm trying to push around this tower from the right side, not giving him a chance to shoot me, and my allies come to my help at this moment and bomb this tank. It's really a hard piece of enemy to be facing in the Sherman. My penetration with the APHE shell is 127mm at 10 meters and 125mm at 100 meters, so basically only side shots will suffice. Now, I am overextending a little in here myself, but I'm trying to position myself so that I can cut off the enemies coming from the spawn. I'm not trying to push really high to be spawn raping. If that should be the case, it's much easier to hide in this rock formation and let them drive past you. As you can see, we have one T-34 near me that is trying to cut the enemies off from the spawn, but he's in the middle of the field and he gets easily spotted, meaning the enemy can kill him very easily. I see the C point is now capped, the point furthest left of my position. And later on in the match you will see that one tank comes from that side and he basically solo caps all 3 points. Take a look how little tickets the enemy has left. It still must be a sure win for us. But since I'm alone on the battlefield. This is now a tricky case of me trying to do all the work by myself. The position I took, or I chose, is pretty decent. I can look all around me, and I am pretty hidden from the enemies coming northeastern spawn, and I'm not sticking out like a sore thumb for the guy coming from B cap. As you can see, in just a moment more I'll be spotting him, and since the T-34 got killed by the Tiger from the B's cap, I am now solo on the ground. I spot some movement in the distance from my commander's view, but I can't make it out yet. I'm hoping that the guys who killed the T-34 are pushing, but they are not moving. So I decide to push out myself, and now I see this Tiger coming over the hill. It's a pretty scary tank for a Sherman facing him sideways. I try to take a shot. I considered taking the shot a few times here, but I wasn't sure I'm gonna penetrate him, so I decided not to take a shot, and now I spot this Hetzer on the hill, meaning that if I'd gone after the Tiger first case, I would have been spotted and killed instantly. I disable his driver, he spots me on the map with his machine guns, but lucky for me, this Tiger didn't pay too much attention. I think he was focused on the capping, so I decide to push in the cap and maybe get a lucky break on this Tiger. The Tiger can be pretty difficult to kill, especially if he's aligned himself in the diamond shape, meaning that the relative thickness of his armor is increased. But I notice him in here, or he notices me, and he gives me a pretty good angle on his front plate. And first time I penetrate him, lucky he doesn't notice me. I get his driver, meaning he doesn't get to back out of the situation, and after my reload I get to hit him the second time. And in here I'm still trying to get the match for us. I know that capping this zone will give me a little more time, and I'm pushing to the edge of the cap circle, so I have the position to move fast to the B, to the middle cap. And I noticed this KB again in the horizon, peeking out. And in here I get a pretty lucky shot. I am range finding him when I peek out. That gives him the perfect time to shoot me. Lucky for me, he just sets me on fire. And I managed to pull off an amazing shot of his lower plate, killing one shot. But this engine fire is the case of us not winning the match. I had to stop and repair my tank, and after the repair, the time was running out very fast for me. And you can see if you want this flavor, I will not manage to get into the middle cap circle. At this moment, of course, all the enemies were pretty much focusing on me, and everybody was pushing me. The engine fire, of course, gave my position away on the map, so they knew exactly where I was. And in here, I'm of course not paying too much attention to my right. I only have eyes for the middle circle, and pushing over it, I see this Panzer IV. I stopped to take a shot at him. managed to snapshot it before he shoots back, but another enemy coming from the spawn and I'm dead, and this is the match too. So thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next video. Like and favorite this shit, and thanks for watching.